The wait is almost over. Rock royalty Paul McCartney is going to command the stage tomorrow night. And as News 5's John London shows us, it's a concert that many people have waited a lifetime to see. John?
Yeah, Jack, a lot of last-minute ticket demand. The box office here closed now for the night, but tickets, a few of them still available online. A lot of juice to the thought of being here for the McCartney concert tomorrow night. Talked to one guy who didn't want to be on camera because he was surprising his wife with tickets. Another guy who just went by here a little while ago is buying tickets for his wife's 14th wedding anniversary. That kind of thing seems to be going on, indicative of how big a deal this is for Cincinnati.
Count lifelong Beatles fan Carla Hoffman among the Cincinnati faithful. Her husband surprised her with McCartney tickets, so she plans to be at Great American Ballpark around this time tomorrow night to see Sir Paul for the first time in a live performance.
I have seen the playlist, 36 songs, two encores, and it was the same for Wrigley and Yankee Stadium, so I'm hoping it's the same because there was some really great music.
We do have tickets for Paul McCartney. That's tomorrow night at Great American Ballpark.
333 seat is getting swamped with last-minute calls about the McCartney show, which will be his first in this city since 93. That gap, combined with the natural aging of a legend and his ageless music, is making people think twice about missing out.
Chances are he's not coming back to Cincinnati. I mean, you know, this could be his last tour. You never know, especially as, you know, performers start to get older in age, and he might not sound the same in a few years, too.
So as the speakers arrive and the stage is set on the field of Great American today, the buzz is building about being part of Cincinnati musical history in a setting normally reserved for hits of a different variety.
It's pretty amazing. I think fans of the ballpark in Cincinnati are really going to be proud of what they see when they come in at showtime tomorrow.
It means everything. I love music. I love concerts. It's a really big deal to me to get to go to this.
And Carla Hoffman hopes to convince her boss to let her head down here a little early tomorrow. I can tell you 333 seat late today said a group came in. They now have some seats, they say, for under $50. Thursday in parts of this city will be given over to talk of McCartney sightings. You know that's going to happen, real or perceived. Reporting live at Great American, John London, News 5.